Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do this survival analysis problem. This is another problem on Kaplan-Meier estimation, so it's my second video doing this type of problem, and I'll put the first video I did in the description box below. So for this problem it says calculate the Kaplan-Meier estimate of S of 4, which is the survival curve at time t is equal to 4, for the following data, and then I have a couple times of both censored and uncensored event times. So I'm just going to go ahead and get started with this problem. Basically what we're going to be doing is estimating the survival curve at time t is equal to 4. So to do that, I'm just going to plug in to the Kaplan-Meier formula for a survival curve, or for estimating the survival curve. And so that is the estimate of S of t is equal to the product of x of j less than or equal to t of 1 minus d of j over y of j. And x of j is going to be defined as the distinct event times. Same as before, d of j is going to be equal to the number of event occurrences at time x of j. And y of j is going to be equal to the number of follow-up times that are at least as big as x of j. So I'm going to write that as the number of times that t of I is greater than or equal to x of j. So from this formula, all you have to do is plug in x of j, d of j, and y of j. And to do that, I'm first going to order my observations from smallest to largest. So that would give me 1, 2, and the value 2 is censored, 2.6, 6, 7, and 9.2, which is censored. So since we want to estimate the survival curve up to time 4, we really only care about these initial values. And then from there, I'm just going to plug in to the formula. So we have two events that happen up to time 4. So we have an event that happens at t is equal to 1 and an event that happens at t is equal to 2.6. So x1, where j is equal to 1, is going to be equal to 1. And x2, where j is equal to 2, is going to be 2.6. So I'm going to have two products. The first product is going to be 1 minus d of j. D of j is equal to the number of occurrences at time x of j. So at time 1, there's one occurrence. And then y of j is equal to the number of follow-up times at least as big as x of j. So at time is equal to 1, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 follow-up times that are at least as big as x of 1. So that gives us our first value for x of 1. Then for x of 2, we're going to have 1 minus d of j. The number of event occurrences at x of 2 is just 1. And then the number of follow-up times is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. And so this is all we have to calculate for s of 4. So we're done plugging everything in, and then that would just give us 5 over 6 times 3 over 4, which is equal to 0.625. And we are done with this problem.